So the third talk of the session is by Manivan Sivan. He's a senior software developer at ZF WABCO. He's going to talk about medical IoT devices and specifically ECG analyzer.
Hello everyone, I'm Manivan from India. I'm here to present my ECG analyzer device.
I have developed an ECG analyzer device based on a TinyML application using Edge Impulse software. This device could detect the atrial fibrillation, first degree outflow, and also a normal case. For this project, I have used an Arduino Nano 33 BLE sense. From a short survey regarding the fatalities due to heart problems in a developing nations and also in a underdeveloped nations, the three major concerns was the rural areas, there was lack of healthcare facilities. And also in a past decade, there was an increase in heart disease cases. And among the people, there was a lack of awareness about the cardiac arrest symptoms. Due to the ignorance, this will lead to the fatality. In a present market, when we see the ECG analyzer device, there are two categories they are following. When you look into the IoT kind of device, this device will send all the bulk ECG data to the mobile or server, and the analysis is done in a high processing computing or in a mobile applications. In the other hand, the computer-based application will receive all the ECG data and it will analyze the patterns. In the above two categories, the one thing is common is it definitely needs the internet dependency and also a high processing computers or a mobile applications. Major motive of my work is to reach a people that they could not able to reach any healthcare facilities and the villages that there is no internet connectivity. My ECG analyzer powered by Edge Impulse will analyze the ECG data without any dependency on the internet, and the latency is very low compared to IoT devices. The outcome of this model, that size will be around a 15 KB ROM, which can be easily ported in any TinyML supported microcontrollers. This is the overall architecture and the flow of my project, like from the data acquisition and simulation and modeling and also a deployment. So I have used a ECG sensor AD8232 and connected to the analog input of the Arduino Nano 33. And I just collected my own heart readings, own ECG readings, and I have copy pasted to the serial from the serial monitor to the Excel data. I have used a MATLAB signal builder to modify the normal ECG data to look like a first degree heart block and the irregular heartbeat, like atrial fibrillation cases. So that's how the MATLAB signal builder will help in this case and in the model training. So once all the data is ready, and I have used a Edge Impulse software to do the model training, and in Edge Impulse itself, I can able to deploy into my Arduino board. Before proceeding with the technical aspect, I want to mention about some ECG terminologies. So you could see here, in a general ECG waves, there will be a small P wave and the larger one will be R1, like we could say as a QRS, and the N1 will be a T. So this is how we used to call a, these are the major points in the ECG waves. If you compare as an interval, PR interval is like a, between the P and the starting of the Q, PR interval. And the RR interval is nothing but the between two R waves, like this, the waves will be keep on coming. So between the R and R is called RR interval. Let's take the atrial fibrillation cases. So you could see the diagram. This is the normal heart conditions, and this is the atrial fibrillation condition. When we compare the ECG waves, you could see that between these two R waves, it is equally distributed. There won't be much difference between this interval and this interval. But if you take the atrial fibrillation cases, you could see that here the interval will be larger, but here the interval will be very smaller between these two RR intervals. So this is how the background of this is. The electrical signal generated from the heart is equally distributed in the normal conditions. But in atrial fibrillation cases, it is a disorganized one, like the electrical signals are not equally distributed towards the heart. So due to that, we could see like abnormal RR intervals. So, and very complication of these cases is like in, if you take any stroke person, like 15 to 20% causes will be like due to the atrial fibrillation cases, like due to the improper pumping of hot blood, and there will be like some clot will happen in the brain. Let's go to the first degree hot block. So in the first degree hot block, interval between the P wave and the QRS complex will be greater than 200 milliseconds. So this is the reason, and also this will cause the atrial fibrillation cases also. So this is a basic terminology I want to clarify before proceeding with the technical aspects. Let's go to the technical one. Once I collected my ECG data, which is a normal one, I want to generate a data sets for atrial fibrillations and also for AV block one, first degree hot block one, which I used to say. Yeah, so I have used a MATLAB signal builder for that. So you could see that from the Arduino serial monitor, I will just collect the data in the Excel sheet. So this is the time log and the data, ECG data. I have used a MATLAB signal builder where I can load this Excel sheet, and you could see in the signal builder, this is a normal ECG waves. So we could able to see that it is equally distributed and there was no difference between P2 QRS sample. So once I get my data into the signal builder, the editing process. So I want to edit, I have edited my ECG normal data to look like a atrial fibrillation cases and also a first degree on block, which is nothing but the AV block one cases. So I can able to drag and modify, and it could able to look like other two cases. So once the modification is done, and I will export that data into a data buffer so that I can use it in my code. So that's how it looks like for a data capturing. So I will collect the data from the analog, I mean 8832, and I modify that my ECG data to look like the other two conditions, and all the data will be converted into a data buffer, and I'll store it in a ecganalyzer.c file, which I have created for my project. So another challenging thing which I faced in the model training is to improve the accuracy of my model. So I want my device should be applicable for anyone, like maybe an elder one or a normal person, and the pulse can be for a person might be a 60, and some person might have a heart pulse as a 110. So the heart pulse is nothing but like it depends upon the difference between the R to R, like how many R waves are occurring in a per minute, the pulse will be calculated. So it will vary for different kind of person. So my model needs to calculate and it needs to predict that atrial and AV block one, irrespective of any heart pulses. Yeah. So what I have done here, like if you could see the atrial fibrillation cases and AV block one. So if the heart pulse is varying, it could not able to predict the normal and atrial fibrillation cases. So my accuracy was lagging, and I have approached a different kind of mechanism to improve my model accuracy. So I just had a conversation with some doctors and experienced person who will analyze the ECG graph, and from them I could able to understand like they will be doing that manual reading between these R2R boxes, the boxes like how many boxes are available between these two R2R wave, and what is the number of box or number of intervals between that P2 order. Like they will write it down and they will see whether the number of boxes are different, is varying or not. So based on that, they could observe, okay, there might be some atrial fibrillation or AV block one. What I've done here, like I have just converted that human observation into a new signal. So I have I could see that this data is available just hiding in the ECG data itself. So I just used ECG analyzer algorithm, which is available in that ECG analyzer library file. It will just get the input as a filtered ECG, and the signal processing will done here there, and it will just split the data into the three different waves. One will be a filtered ECG and the RR interval and the PR interval. So based on that, my model accuracy is increased. So here you could see the human observation on my ECG analyzer data sets. Okay. For a normal people, there won't be any deviation. So I just set RR interval is 100 and PR interval is 50. For atrial fibrillation cases, we could see there will be a deviation between the two RR intervals. So once that kind of observation is observing, and the wave will be keep on transferred to minus 100. So it's like from 100 to minus 100, it will be changed. And for first degree hot block, whenever there is a time gap between this P2OR increases beyond 200 milliseconds, my PR interval value will change to minus 50. So that's how this data looks like. So whenever in a normal ECG, there will be no drop in OR interval and no PR interval drop. But in atrial fibrillation cases, we could see that there will be a drop in OR interval wave, and that amplitude will be like minus 100. And the first degree outlook, there will be a drop in a PR interval. So that's how it looks like. So once I collected a lot amount of data, and I have used a example software where I have set the window length as a 3000 milliseconds, like a 3 seconds, like a 3 seconds in the sense might be like a 3 to 4 OR waves can occur in that category, like that can able to identify the whether is there any deviation in OR or a P wave. And the outcome of the model is I could able to achieve the accuracy 92.9%, and I have trained using the 40 epoch, and the confidence rating I have set it as 0.65, and I could able to do the second degree hot block also, but sometimes the second degree hot block will sometimes misjudged into the atrial fibrillation cases, but the accuracy will be around 80 when we include that second degree hot block. My outcome of this model, TinyML model, is nothing, it's not depends only on Arduino, like it's a ECG analyzer library where we can able to port it into any micro TinyML supported microcontrollers. It might be a Nordic or a Scilabs or an Arduino, and we can connect the analog sensor, ECG sensor into that, and we can able to train the model using the Edge Impulse software, and we can able to deploy in any TinyML supported microcontrollers using Edge Impulse software. So that's how the library portability will work. Yeah, now the demo session. I'll show my demo.
This follows a three-led ECG system where the red one will be placed under the right shoulder, and the left yellow one will be placed under the left shoulder, and the green one will be placed in the lower left ribs. And this algorithm will run for 1 minute of time. After the 1 minute of time, the collected ECG data will be analyzed, whether it can predict that normal or atrial fibrillation or a AV block one case. And also this algorithm also can run in a simulated way. Like here we could see that I have simulated the atrial fibrillation case, and the percentage was 99%. So that's how it works.
Mani Banan for the presentation.
Thank you. I have shared my GitHub code also. Like, if anyone wants to try that, they can try that. It's an open source. They can experiment. Like, we can add a further heart disease cases.
You can add it in the chat if you want. People sure. Can have a look.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
I don't see a question at the moment. Maybe I can ask something. So you showed in the presentation that you generate simulated data. My question is, how do you make sure that the artificial changes that you impose on the data do not distort it in a way that is not realistic?
Yeah, okay, like this project was done by like, I'm just having a, just collaborated with some doctors, like they give me that input, like how the normal will be. And I just simulated that output in the MATLAB, and I showed to them like, okay, whether it is an atrial fibrillation or not. So they will just verify in their experience level, and they will come back to me, okay, this is the editor one is correct one. So based on that, I'll just make sure that, okay, this label will be atrial fibrillation cases. So that that will be analyzed in my library. So and I could able to experiment in different methodologies and came expected output. So that's how it's like as a engineer, it has some dependency on a doctor's also.
Okay, very good. Thank you.
This would not be made possible without our sponsors, whom I would like to once again express our gratitude, starting by premier sponsored Newton.ai. Thank you guys so much. The executive sponsors, which involve ARM, Edge Impulse, Qualcomm AI, and Syntiant. The platinum sponsors, which involve Infineon, Reality AI. The gold sponsors, which involved Latent AI, SenseML. And last but not least, our silver sponsors, which involve EMSA, Greenwaves, Kixo, Imagimob, HOTC, Seed Studio, and ST Microelectronics. Thank you, everybody. See you all tomorrow with more exciting features.